We went for a walk, decided to come check out the permaculture area. Haven't been here in a while, wanted to see what it's become since the new Kalani took over. And I gotta say, wow, they have really done a lot with this place. This is probably the highlight of Kalani. I think it's what the founding members of the permaculture area, the permaculture department back in the day had in mind. I wish they were here to see how great it's become. Look at this. They have a sign here that is just so immaculate and neatly written, everything. As you can see, to attract and feed fungi and bacteria and on, they put a lot of thought into this, and I think that's awesome. I applaud them. And it goes on and it is important because it creates aerobic conditions that support beneficial microorganisms, blah blah blah, etc. I'm not being sarcastic, I really do think it's cool. Look how organized they are. Come with me. Let me show you how organized they are. They have, all their screws are in jars. They're not all jumbled together. I'm not going to touch them because it's their business. I'm not going to interfere with anything they have going on, but they have flat enamel paint. I'm sure somewhere on this property there's black marks on something from that paint. I think that's pretty good. I appreciate that. As a longtime Kalani supporter, I really do appreciate what they're doing here. The world is a brighter place because of you. Because of you. I'm talking to you. And me too, I guess. I don't know. This could use a little sprucing up. It's getting a little faded. It looks like there's written with a marker that was in its last stages. Yeah, other than that, I think they've done a lot here. This is very cool. Seeing all these new plants? This is progress. This is a sign that somebody really cares. I feel so much sacred energy just emanating from this place. It's amazing. Because, you know, like, I'm into tarot cards, and this reminds me of the Empress card. The Empress, in a lot of ways, represents the sacred feminine in tarot. And I feel this is an Empress garden. So if you're into tarot, this is the living embodiment of that archetype. And yeah, I think it's awesome. I feel good here. I wish I could just bring a sleeping bag and camp here tonight and just bask in all this wonderful energy and just have really cool, wonderful dreams tonight. But I can't, because I just don't really, I don't actually want to. But in my mind, I can see where that would be a cool thing. So yeah, I'm sure this one is reserved for even more of what you see here. I'm very impressed. You hear what we're hearing? There's a party going on. I have so much admiration for these people right now. They are not letting social distancing during the coronavirus. As we film this, coronavirus is still plaguing this world and we're all staying away from each other. But they're not letting that stop them from having a good time. They are celebrating life. They are celebrating existence on the planet. I wish I had been invited. I wouldn't have gone because I'm really not a social person and I don't even know these people that well. And I don't think I actually want to know them that well. But I'm not going to let that taint anything I'm feeling about them or seeing about them. I'm serious. I can hear it. They are having the time of their life. Update on the maintenance department. It's become an even gianter parking lot for junk cars. More junk cars here. There's an Altima that wasn't used to be here. And it's supposed to be inspected on month 6. I don't think it's going to happen. I think it's been abandoned. Look, there's junk on the window. Nobody's cleaning that. Nobody cares anymore. It's just a junkyard. Used to be a great place, now it's just a junkyard. my God. Or more to the point, what's not here anymore? There's no hammock there anymore. That hammock was a staple of Kalani. It was a landmark. People walking up the trail, yes, volunteers alike, would see the hammock. There would always be somebody relaxing in it. It was the greatest spot on Kalani, except maybe for the hot tub and the sauna. But it's gone now. We don't know what happened. None of the hammocks are here. There used to be four hammocks. There started off one back when I was new here. Then they added another one down there. Then in the last couple of years, they added these other two, but now they're all gone. It's a mystery to us. We've been hypothesizing as to what they were thinking when they took the hammocks down. Is this in response to the coronavirus, or are they concerned that it's an airborne virus and that by swinging in the air, you're gonna catch it? It doesn't make sense, and it's sad. It's very sad. The swing that used to be there, that's gone too. I have so many memories of watching children play on that swing, because, you know, this place isn't really designed, or wasn't at the time, still isn't, designed for children. So children liked the swing, and they had fun on that. And now it's gone, like so much else at Kalani. They say they're rebuilding, but are they really? Are they really rebuilding if they're taking hammocks down? I still have faith. I want to believe that they know what they're doing. I think they do. I feel like they do. I support them. I want them to succeed. But I don't think it's going to happen without hammocks. This one too. This one's gone too. Like I was saying down there, we have no idea what happened to the hammocks here. Now, honestly, we're a little concerned. I mean, what's the logic? Is there logic? I don't know if there's logic involved. Maybe somebody just came in and said, you know what? Fuck you guys, I'm gonna take your hammocks. And then they ran off with all the hammocks. I don't know. But I don't like it one bit. It's part of Kalani, you know? This is what people think about. When they think about Kalani, they think about the food, they think about the swimming pool, they think about the hammocks. Some of them think about yoga. Some of them think about e-dance. Most of them think about the hammocks, including me. That was one of my first impressions of Kalani when I was a guest here in 2006. And one of the reasons I fell in love with this place and wanted to spend my life here, because they had nice hammocks. But they're gone. I might as well leave too. You know what? I'm never coming. Another hammock that's gone. Nothing but empty air here now. You know what else is gone? The swing at the point. We don't know. I don't know. Do you know? I don't know. But the hammock that was here, people playing volleyball right behind us would take a break saying, oh, I'm so tired from hitting a ball over a net. I need a nap. So I'm going to go to that hammock. Call me when you need to be up. Kobo's got some competition for the alpha dog of Kalani now. We found this dog, came running up to us, barking its head off, trying to scare us away. And, you know, we acted like we were scared. We didn't want to undermine that poor dog's confidence. We want him to feel fierce, or her, I think it's a she. We want her to feel fierce. We want her to feel like she is vital to the security force here at the new Kalani. So we acted all afraid and kind of ran away, but then we just started laughing. We couldn't really keep up the charades, and now the dog is just slinking away like she's a failure. Sorry, dog, we didn't mean to undermine your confidence. But you gotta, it's up to you, dog, to be more fierce. You gotta jump, you gotta pounce. You can't just stand 20 feet away and bark. It doesn't work. Nobody's gonna be afraid of that. This is me just giving you some friendly advice. Be fierce if you want to scare people away. As far as this hammock situation goes, the one that particularly breaks my heart to lose is the one that used to be way down there by the lower lanai. we would walk down there and show you where it used to be, but honestly, we're just kind of tired right now. We don't really feel like walking. We're taking a break. But anyway, that hammock has a lot, had, past tense, had a lot of personal connections to me. That's where I shot my first Kalani video. I've made several here over the years. It was the hammock safety video. That was so much fun to make back in 2008. That's before Shanita Psychopath. It was just a short film. No, wait, it was after Shanita Psychopath. That was my second video I made at Kalani. It was my first short video. It was a lot of fun to make. I was with a friend of mine, Amy from Canada.
Damn you, white man. May you rot and burn in hell.
Wonder how she's doing these days. Who knows? Anyway, it's gone. Part of me is gone. My heart's broken. Yeah. Hate to say it, but this is probably going to be the next to go. Somebody's going to confuse it for a hammock because, look, it's netting, just like a hammock is. These people, like I was saying before, I want to support them. I want to feel good about what they're doing here. But sometimes some of the decisions they've been making is just making me question, is my loyalty to the new Kalani well placed? Or should I abandon all hope? I don't want to abandon hope. I love this place. I want to see this place continue. And I support them. Just, this is not a hammock. Remember that. It's a volleyball net. Treat it with respect. Somebody might want to come play volleyball here again. That's all I'm saying. Christmas never ends at Kalani. Isn't this nice? It is May. We're just talking about Tony Thompson's birthday. It's May. Christmas never ends. This is a beautiful place. This warms my heart. I feel good. All the stuff I was talking about, the hammocks and all that, this kind of makes up for it. Just seeing the beauty, the festive nature of these Christmas decorations in May. I don't know. I just feel really good right now. What do you think of this place now? Remember when this was just a tent with a table and some chairs you could sit at, get out of the rain when you're at the pool? Look at it now. We have a chandelier. We have that fancy light. Look at that. Look. Have you seen it? Did you ever imagine that this would be Kalani? This is Kalani. It's wonderful. This is living the life. This is lifestyle of the rich and famous Kalani. Wow, why couldn't this been like this when I was a volunteer here? All those years I sat under a tent, or was it this structure? Anyway, it was just a table and a couple of chairs. Why couldn't they have done this when I was here? What were you thinking, Richard? You could have done this. Why didn't you, Richard? Why didn't you step up? Well, I'm just gonna bask in it. Place still a haven for artists. Check out the sauna. It's looking good, isn't it? Looks like some kind of giant octopus theme with little fishies swimming towards and around and from and to that octopus. Very fancy. Yeah. Nice try, whoever tried to cut a pool cover for the pool. A little small, didn't quite get the dimensions right. And as you can see, because of your error, the pool at this moment, I'm sure it'll be fine later, but at this moment, it's a filthy mess. Ugh. I just feel like taking a look at the gym. I'm not gonna exercise. I go for walks, that's my exercise. Yeah, the gym's still here. I don't see anything different about this place. That's good, at least some things have remained the same through all the changes at Kalani. It's good to see that there are constants in this world. If you ever use this gym, it's still here. If you ever make it back, it'll still be here. If Kalani survives, it'll still be here. I hope everything is good in the world soon. We were curious to see how Ahomai Village is doing. It's been a while since we've walked through here. So we're just gonna see what's new, what's different, what's changed, what's the same. I don't really have any expectations. I don't know what to expect. Let's see. There's some pigs over there. Some things never change. I used to live in that A-frame. That used to be my spot at one point. I lived in a lot of A-frames. I lived in a lot of different places here at Kalani. Right now though, Ahomai Village just feels dead. There's no life, no volunteers, nobody running around in towels, going to the shower, taking naps after their shift. Feels like a graveyard. Almost like I'm walking through a back alley I shouldn't be walking through. I feel like I don't belong here anymore. This isn't really my place anymore. Look, we got cars parked here now. They look lived in. I think people live in these cars. Something about the structures aren't good enough for them, so they want to live in their cars instead. Well, that's their business. I'm just observing, just walking through and looking. Well, there's at least one B-frame that hasn't been sold off. A couple years ago, the old board of directors was selling off all the structures here, supposedly to pay the bills at Kalani, but looks like not all the bills got paid. Did they really use the money to pay the bills? Well, that's all speculation. I don't know. I don't have any answers. Nice bamboo, at least. Appreciate bamboo. It's one of the perfect things in this world. Getting up on the ghetto. Except the ghetto isn't there anymore. The ghetto is just a memory. Board of directors, like I was saying, selling off structures. They sold the ghetto. Every piece of the ghetto is gone. Nothing but overgrown cane grass where B-frames and A-frames and cabanas used to be. And the lawn that needs to be mowed. That's what remains of the ghetto. This is actually a nice thing here at Kalani. This is a good idea. They should have done this years ago. They took the meadow, remember the meadow? They turned it into a parking lot. That is a good idea. People come in for whatever reason, can park down here, walk up there, relieves congestion, less cars driving around. And those horses that were here, they really didn't contribute to Kalani that much. I mean, they were nice, but they're really just decoration. What did those horses really have to do with anything at Kalani? Guests couldn't ride them. They could just walk by and say, oh, look at the horse, how nice. The horses, yeah, I mean, why did we have those horses? This is better off as a parking lot. I truly, in my heart, say that with sincerity.
They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. They paved paradise, put up a parking lot.
Of a parking lot.
Remember that exhilarating feeling you used to have zooming out over the ocean here or near the ocean, back and forth, back and forth? Remember how good that made you feel, how peaceful and just like the world is just a perfect place? Well, that's all you have now are the memories. The swing's gone. We don't know who took it. It's one of the great mysteries of Puna. Who took the swing at the point? And more to the point, why? Why did somebody come and take this beautiful landmark, this treasure of the island? Why did they cut it? It's cut. It's gone. Just like the swing up top, just like all the hammocks, everything you could possibly swing in the air in is no longer available to anybody. We don't know why. An interesting interesting factoid I bet you didn't know. After the lava flow in 2018, the bench at the point vanished. It disappeared. Somebody said, oh, I'm going to take advantage of this desperate time and go steal a bench. However, the bench has been restored thanks to Crandall and Keith. You remember Keith? You remember Crandall? Well, they said, no, this won't stand. We need a bench there. So they came back, they cemented a new bench into the ground. It would be very difficult for anybody to steal it. So we thank you, Crandall. We thank you, Keith. Now, if we could only solve the mystery of that swing. You can read all about this in Touch. We've written about it. We're offering a reward for anybody who has information about the whereabouts of the swings, the hammocks, all these things that have gone missing. As we enjoy our walk around Kalani, we stopped here at the front of Hale Aloha. Mikey is still here. You'll be glad to know that. He's still working. He's taking care of the landscaping here. Look, this is beautiful. I've never seen it look so nice here. Well, that was a nice walk around Kalani. Brought back a lot of memories. Whenever I'm at Kalani nowadays, after the closure and all that, after the lava flow, going for walks, I swear it's like walking through a ghost town for me personally. I mean that because so many memories come back to me. Every step is like another memory and ghosts coming out of the woodwork, out of the jungle. So it's really nice to just see that it's still surviving. Kalani is still alive. It's been through a lot. It's been through the lava flow. It's been through hurricanes. We had Derek here for a while. But through it all, Kalani stands. Hey, como mai. These benches on Kalani property, these were LJ's idea. I don't know how many of you remember LJ. I don't know how many of you even knew the guy, but he was the executive director for a while. And he said, you know what, we need benches. So I thought I would just remember LJ. I like the guy personally. If you have memories of Kalani, if you want to remember, if you want to relive some of it, I'm just going to let you know, we have the In Touch book coming out June 2nd. That is the anniversary of the last person to leave Kalani after it is shut down because of the volcano. Oh, that was a rough time, but we got through it. We're having better times now. Things are getting better. Things go up and down, up and down, up and down. I think they're smoothing out eventually. We're going to get through whatever we're going through now, and it's just going to be good. So be watching for In Touch book. It's going to be spectacular. We are offering it as a PDF, and yeah, it's coming. Wait for it. It's worth the wait.
Always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone. They paid paradise, put up a parking lot. They took all the trees, put them in a tree museum, and they charged the people $1.50 just to see them.